Hey, Collective. So today was supposed to do the Earth signs, but didn't get a chance to get to the Earth signs. You know, you guys know that there is, you know, tower stuff going on for me. But I did want to. I usually don't get a whole lot of views like on the videos for the astrological signs anyways. So, but I still made a promise to you guys. But I will get the earth signs done tomorrow. But I still wanted to get on and give you guys a message because I had a free moment and I was like, you know what? I feel drawn to get on and do a message. And also, as soon as I sat down to start recording, I went into this massive like coughing fit. So there could be like some throat chakra issues or some communication issues going on for those of you that come across this message. Not for all of you, but some of you may be dealing with that. So just wanted to see like what your angels want to say, like what kind of messages. This is going to be a very quick message for you guys. So let's go ahead and use the singing bowl, clear out the energy. Also, please forgive the fact my nails, you guys know I love my long beautiful nails, but can't do it right now. But as soon as I can, I'm headed straight to the nail salon. Sorry. Oh, my dogs got over here and chewed up some stuff under my desk and I just don't know what it is. Oh, okay. I'll just deal with that later. Okay. For those of you who don't know me, hi, my name is Winter. I'm claircognizant, clairvoyant, clairsentient, and clairaudient. I use my gifts and abilities as well as my knowledge of the cards to channel messages from the divine for you. So let's go ahead and clear out the energy. And call upon our spirit team. You guys can visualize a healing light surrounding you. And then just ask either your angels or your spirit guides. You can ask the universe to connect and communicate with you. But this will be messages from your angels. So if you want, you can just ask your angels, your guardian angels, any angels that want to come through to communicate with you. That's of your highest good. Thank you, Divine Holy Spirit, angels, archangels, Archangel Sandalphon, Archangel Michael, Archangel Metatron. Thank you, Ascendant Masters, Ancestors of the Highest Good, Spirit Guides, and Angelic Higher Light Beings. You are invited here into this space tonight to help me grasp messages and answers that need to be delivered to any and all souls that find their way here. I thank you for guiding, blessing, and protecting this reading for myself and the collective. Thank you for allowing me to clearly and accurately see, hear, feel, and know the messages that you have for the collective. Thank you for using each and every one of the decks of cards that I use here tonight as tools to communicate, to bring clarity, insight, guidance, validation, confirmation, information that comes from love. Thank you for honest, accurate, trustworthy answers and messages from the divine that are only of the highest good and to the harm of none. With peace, love, light, and gratitude, so it is. Namaste. So this is just going to be a very general reading, you guys. And there are many people that will be drawn to this. I mean, I don't know how many, but more, you know, more than one. So it's not a personal reading. So you'll have to take it how it resonates for your particular situation. I'm not going to be coming up with like a personal story, because like I said, it is collective. So only take the parts that resonate and leave what doesn't resonate. Okay. And if it all resonates, perfect. And if parts resonate, that's perfectly fine too. Okay. Thank you, Divine Holy Spirit, angels, archangels. Thank you, spirit guides, angelic higher light beings, and any ancestors. Please come here, guide this reading. I do see someone that is closing the door on the past, or like a past person, a past situation. Somebody may have actually even done like some sort of cord cutting ceremony. I feel like Archangel Michael is really connected with a lot of you. Also, Archangel Sandalphon is really connected with you at this time. Okay. The first card out here is mediumship. You guys, I've been getting this a lot. Like, was it been like two readings? It was like two readings in a row where I got the mediumship for you guys. I hate that. You guys, my nails are like this. Oh my God. Anyways, but anyways, you are very connected with departed loved ones at this time. You actually have this natural ability to connect with spirits that have crossed over. Some of you maybe like feel when a spirit is in the room. This, like, even as a child, I feel like a lot of you could do this. In fact, I'm seeing someone like run and jump in their bed as a child because like you could feel like this spirit, and it would like, and it's almost like it scared you. So like maybe you would like run upstairs like really fast, or like you would run down the hallway really fast because you could feel the energy of a spirit and there was like this scary feeling. But whatever kind of feelings that you're receiving, any thoughts, any visions, like, you know, seeing, getting like these just random images in your head, you know, like even when you close your eyes, maybe like these crazy random images that maybe, like I told you guys before, that make you feel half crazy, because spirit is showing me that again here with the mediumship card. Showing me that again, that same message. So like whatever this is that you're receiving, those images that you see in your head, like maybe hearing someone else's voice in your head, trust that, because those are real. They're real. Those are real messages from spirit. This is a very real healing for yourself and for others, since it does convey, you know, peaceful and loving messages from heaven. Okay, you have this natural healing ability to heal others, to bring peace to them. So like maybe you'll hear or feel a message that says, I love you, I'm fine, you know, I'm proud of you, or even like, I apologize. Those things, those are real messages. You're not making it up, and it's not like, and just because it's like, it feels very like, maybe it feels like a very generic message because it's not anything like huge and profound and like, and whatever, but it's like you, if you're talking to someone and all of a sudden you hear, I'm proud of you, that is a message for that, for you to give someone else. Oh, I just heard I'm proud of you. And that message means everything to the other person, because they may have been wondering, is my crossed over loved one proud of me? That's how it works. That's how I receive messages as well. And I do feel like I'm connecting with other mediums here, you know, so really, work on trusting this particular calling that you have, you know, so that you are able to help others, you know, help others connect with their crossed over loved ones, you know. So I do see that you, the like you can see both sides, that spirit veil is very sheer, and you're able to connect with both realms, many different realms. It's like you're here to be of service to others because of that. So, yeah. Other messages do you have for the collective? Past life issues. All right, so some of you are actually dealing with challenges in this lifetime that are related to previous lifetimes. So, you know, like maybe even doing like a past life reading. Also, we've got singing and dancing on the bottom of the deck. So some of you may want to really practice doing like some singing and dancing. And I think it's so crazy because I've got past life issues and singing and dancing that just showed up here. And I literally just did a reading for a subscriber, a personal reading. And we actually even got something very similar to this about a past life with singing and dancing. So, you know, I feel like a lot of you too, they're like, you're actually receiving images from past life. Like you are having past life memories with this mediumship card and the past life issues showing up there. But you may be wondering like, what is that? Like, you know, what are those images? And it may, and that's because they are memories, they're past life memories that are surfacing. And so really focusing on like tuning into that, expressing what you're seeing, hearing, feeling, those things that are really connected with this past life. I feel like a lot of you are having past life memories and you don't even realize that that's what it is. Like ideas and just random thoughts that are popping up. Guys, those are your past life memories. If this is resonating with you at all, if this feels like, yeah, that makes sense to you, that's because you are remembering your past life and you are a medium and you have this mission to help bring messages to others, to tell them about their crossed over loved ones. And you are also like able to like give people messages about their own past lives. Some of you are able to do that. What other messages do you have? Okay, books. So, all right. And also if you're watching me right now, you are an indigo child. Okay. You're just highly sensitive to energies. And many of you, with that books card, like you could actually, some of you, be into like reading, writing, you know, like maybe, even like selling like spiritually based books, like it says here, but others of you, it's like, right now, or you could be going into this energy of like soaking up as much information about spirituality, about your gifts, you know, like maybe even like learning about like reading books about, you know, like spirituality, reading books about like what happens when you die. I'm seeing someone actually reading about reincarnation, or like you're just doing a lot of studying and research in general with regards to like spirituality or just like any area of your life, like something that involves like gaining information and wisdom. But a lot of you, you know, you could be into like journaling, drawing, excuse me. Yeah. Okay. So we're just going to get one more message and then I'm going to let you guys go. We're not going to go real in depth. I just wanted to do a quick message for you guys. Thank you, Divine Holy Spirit, angels, archangels, ascended masters, ancestors, spirit guides, higher light beings, angelic higher light beings, what messages can you give to the person watching spirit, the collectives of, look, there's something better. So some of you may be really in a place, you've got a lot on your mind with this reconsider card here. Okay. Excuse me, I'm so sorry. You either have a lot on your mind or there's something in particular that's weighing heavily on your mind, okay? And so, but Spirit is telling you that it is going to work out for the better for you, all right? To know that whatever struggles you're going through currently, it is going to all work out for your benefit. It is all, everything is going to fall into place is what I just heard for some of you. I do feel like I need to clarify this, but something better. There's like something on the horizon that you don't even realize just yet. Like, and this is, this is like something that you're just going to be like, why did I let this worry me so much? Why did I let that weigh on my mind so heavily? And Spirit's like, you know what? It's something so much better. You know, we saved this for you. Like, we saved this is something that I'm hearing. For some of you, this is an actual relationship. You are being taken to some, to a person that's better suited for you. I'm not saying a better person, okay, because there, nobody is any better than anybody else, but this person is better suited for you. This person, as far as a job, this job is so much better for you. There's a house that's better than what you, were thinking it was going, you know, that you would end up with. There's, you know, it's like, whatever this is, it's so much better than you can imagine. So don't let this stress you out, whatever this is that's weighing on your mind. Yeah, the Five of Cups, like you're sitting there thinking, like thinking on the negatives, okay? Like thinking worst case scenario, but Spirit's like, oh my God. And then look, the King of Swords, like here it is. It's weighing heavily on your mind right now, you know? And, but Spirit's like, just you wait. You know, just you wait. Just there's a silver lining, okay? There's a silver lining. Just you wait. It's going to be so much better than you could have ever imagined. Oh my God, I love this, you guys. I'm so excited. I just cannot wait to hear when you guys tell me what this is for you. Like, I just, and I know that you deserve it. Like that, and there's something that's happening for you that it's almost like you never dreamed it could have happened. This is something that that you allowed your higher self, your real self, your higher self allowed to happen to you in this lifetime because your higher self, you knew that you could handle this, okay? Because you've done it before, you've done it in a past life. But it was, it's like, it's almost like this time around, it's like, I don't know, I'm hearing rite of passage. It's like this time around, you know, because your soul loves to achieve, you know, loves to overcome struggles and adversities, no matter how big or small, you know? And so, this is absolutely amazing, and I'm so excited for you. So this is what I have for you guys, and the divine in me bows to the divine in you. Namaste.